हॅलो डियर स्टुडंट्स, माय नेम इज श्वेता पाटील. आय एम फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी, चांगुकांना ठाकूर कॉलेज, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स सायन्स, न्यू पनवेल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक सॉफ्टवेअर क्वालिटी अश्युरन्स. अँड इन द टॉपिक सॉफ्टवेअर क्वालिटी अश्युरन्स, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक वॉट इज मीन बाय क्वालिटी, वॉट आर द टर्मिनॉलॉजीज ऑफ द क्वालिटी. इन केस ऑफ क्वालिटी देअर आर सो मेनी व्ह्यूज ऑफ द क्वालिटी, सो हाऊ वी आर गोइंग टू डिफाईन दोज टाईप ऑफ द क्वालिटी. अगेन इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड वी आर गोइंग टू सी वॉट इज मीन बाय द पी डी सी ए सायकल. सो वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ द पी डी सी ए सायकल, सो दॅट वी आर गोइंग टू सी वन बाय वन. सो लेट्स सी द टुडेज टॉपिक स्टुडंट्स. सो फर्स्ट इज अ क्वालिटी. वॉट इज मीन बाय क्वालिटी? क्वालिटी इज नथिंग बट द फिटनेस फॉर यूथ्स. सो वॉट एवर द टाईप ऑफ द क्वालिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट इज देअर, दॅट इज फॉर द कस्टमर सॅटिस्फॅक्शन. वॉट इज अ नीड ऑफ द क्वालिटी? What are the expectation of the quality and how you are going to define those need for the customer basis. So this is the first quality definition said by the Juron. So that is the main thing in the quality, that whatever the product you are buying, so that product having the great quality in terms of the product. Second, that is a conformance to specification. So that is defined by the Crosby. What is mean by the conformance to the specification, student? So conformance to specification is nothing but, so quality will always depend on the customer requirement. Suppose customer is giving the requirement, so that basis customer is going to define what type of the requirements are there. So for example, addition of the two number program is there. So for the addition, we will require the three variable addition variable, that is a variable 1, variable 2 and the variable 3. So in the first two variable we are going to do the addition of the two number, then this addition we are going to store into the third number. Okay, so for the addition we will require the this type of the requirement. So whatever the requirement is there, that requirement will be defined by the customer and this requirement should be correct. So that is a conformance to specification. Quality always support the conformance. Third is the degree of excellence or superiority in the kind. So quality will always support the degree of excellence. It contains the base review of the customer and that review will be measured in terms of the superiority in the kind. Okay. And the fourth quality definition, delivering product that meet the customer needs. So whatever the product you are going to deliver to the customer, that will fulfill all the requirement of the customer. Next, so there are the different perspective towards the quality of the product. The first perspective, that is a customer based definition of the quality. So what is mean by the customer based definition of the quality? Quality will always taking the requirement from the customer, what is the specification of the customer, and that specification will always need to support the customer. So that is the customer based definition of the quality. Second is the manufacturing based definition of the quality. Customer will not interfere in the manufacturing based definition of the quality. Why? Because whenever customer will interfere in this type of the particular type, then it will be very risky. So manufacturing base always designed by the producer, and that producer will always maintain the quality. Third is product based definition of the quality. You have to check the two product at the same level, means existing product and the new product. So whenever there is a comparison between the existing and the new product, at that time you are going to take the best quality product for the customer. Okay. Next is value based definition of the quality. In case of value based definition of the quality, customer will always value for the product. So at the time of the acceptance testing, what is mean by acceptance testing, students? Acceptance testing is nothing but what? It is at the user level. So whenever you are launching the whole product, so after launching the whole product, the maintenance should be done at the customer level. Okay, so customer will always value the product, that is from the producer. And last is the transcendent quality. What is mean by the transcendent quality? Transcendent quality is nothing but that quality of the product will always helpful to the customer. Customer will satisfy from those quality of the product. In the next, The third slide, that is a process model. So how the process modeling can be done? There are the three parameters. First is the input. We are collecting the input from the customers. So that input should be always correct. Okay. Suppose any website you are going to design, any product you are going to purchase. So for this product purchasing, you are going to define the requirement, that is the input. So input are the test cases in case of the software quality parameter. And after performing the input, we are going to process those input. Means whatever the input you are going to take from the customer, we are going to define the process on those input. And finally launching the main product in the market, that is the output. Okay. So these three parameters are mainly used in the process model. And after output, they will give you the feedback. Output will give you the feedback to the input. Means whatever the input test cases you have designed will be getting the greater output. Okay. So input is a customer requirement. Process means we are going to process on those input. And the output, we are getting the output from those type of the input. Okay. In the next, we are going to see continuous improvement cycle, that is a PDCA cycle. Okay. So what the PDCA stands for? P stands for plan, D stands for do, C stands for check, and the A stands for act. Okay. So what is this in the PDCA cycle? PDCA cycle is the continuous improvement cycle that is used in the software development. So accordingly, the first phase you are going to see, that is the plan. Okay. So you are planning the goals and the missions, whatever the vision of your branching, of your organization, or of your perspective. Okay. So planning all those requirements together in the planning phase. So you have to set the vision and mission for your organization. Second is the do. Whatever the vision and mission you have organized, you have to update all the requirement from the planning phase. You have to take some necessity, you have to take some goals, and for those goals you are getting the requirement from the customer. Okay, so you have to check what type of the requirement are there, why this requirement we are going to use, what will happen with those type of the requirement, and why there is a necessity of those requirement. Okay. In the third phase, that is the check. Check is nothing but the comparison between the existing requirement and the current requirement. Okay. So you are checking regularly what type of the model that we are going to see. And the last step, that is the act. Act means action based on those requirement. And this cycle is a never ending cycle, students. Why? Because this phase will continue towards the development. Okay. So whatever the development type is there, so that will be developed, and according to that type of the development will be necessity throughout the software development. Okay. So we are planning, we are then doing, then check, and the act. So this cycle will continuous, and this is the never ending cycle. So this cycle is used in the software development. Okay. So this is all for today, students. So we have discussed what is mean by quality, its parameter, what is nothing but the process model. Then we have discussed what is mean by PDCA cycle. Thank you for listening, everyone.